This is Finding Our Way, the official podcast of the band Wayland. We are taking you back to 2016 and diving deep, song per song, into the Wayland album, Rinse and Repeat. Now give a warm warrior welcome to your hosts, Mitch Arnold and Phill Valinsky.
Welcome back to Finding Our Way, the official podcast of the band Wayland.
Yes.
Mitch and Phill from the band Wayland here diving into Rinse and Repeat, which is a really cool record with some awesome artwork. And we are here at Back to Life.
Yeah.
Which is a really heavy, awesome song.
I mean, listening to it, to me, it was, you know, we got to explore a lot of our influences on this record. And to me, like, from the guitar standpoint, it was very Soundgarden-y.
Yes.
What's that other band that he had?
Audioslave.
Yeah, Audioslave.
This was very Audioslave, yeah.
Like that chorus pedal with all the, you know, that thing that definitely, like,
very Tom.
No, that's like a that's like Soundgarden thing. Like, it's all like,
oh, is it really?
Oh yeah, for sure. Like in Black Hole Sun.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yeah. So man, I think we were toward the end of the record with the writing, and this whole time with this album, we were paying for it ourselves while touring, and we were looking for management. We had a manager, but we were exploring.
We were looking for a team.
Yeah, exactly. You know, possibly a label partner. I remember doing a lot of agent interviews, and it was frustrating. We were hearing so many things from so many people telling us what our band should be, and this song, I feel like, especially those lyrics in the chorus, were really about that frustration of being dragged through it.
Right.
When we were the only ones that really understood what we were trying to do and where we were going. And we knew this record was not a radioactive rock record, like right down the center, like I think some people were hoping for.
Right.
We were getting a little bit weird. We were putting mandolin and some banjo and some pedal steel and stuff like that and some of the upcoming songs,
right,
the bongos and the organ. We were starting to just find our voice and express the way it wasn't going to be a rock record. It was going to be more of a rock and roll record.
Yes.
You know, and some people were confused by that were around us at the time.
Yes.
And, that's one thing that was really great is because we were the ones paying for it with our money from the road, still paying ourselves our $120 a week or whatever it is.
Yeah.
We were sacrificing all that to be able to make this record. We really did not have to listen to anybody.
It's true.
And we got to take it to whoever we wanted to mix it, and we got to do the artwork how we wanted it. And now, as I appreciate that about our management, Jesse at the time, who like really empowered us to do that, you know, to do it ourselves, whether we were going to fall on our face with it or not, you know.
Do you feel like it being such a different record, you know, top to bottom, the different songs on it, do you think that played a role in all these people around us having a different opinion on which direction it should go?
Totally, because you could take two songs as a focus track or as focus tracks, and they would give you one idea of what the record's going to be like.
Right.
Or you could take two other ones, and that could totally change what your perception of the rest of the record is going to sound like.
Yeah.
And we even had a lot of people mix it, too.
That's
we
right.
We went to one mixer, but I mean, like, we had people do these test mixes.
Yeah.
And the way they mixed it would make it a certain thing, I think going with Jeff in the end, he made it very colorful with all the percussion being loud and the harmonies being loud.
Yes.
But we did, I mean, we had this guy that I know, he had mixed like Metallica. He did one. We had some guy in Texas do one. The guy in Texas did like a real, somehow it sounded like really kind of rootsy, like, everyone has their own take on it.
Yes.
And the mix played a big role.
Yeah.
For sure. And I mean, Justin, the producer, did a whole mix, the whole thing. And he was kind of annoyed, I remember, that we went and had someone else remix it.
Yeah, I remember that as well.
But I'm glad we did, because, you know, when a producer puts all their heart and soul into a record, they want to, sometimes I feel, and I'm guilty of this myself as a producer, you want to hear every part.
Yeah, and so you,
so you can't let that go or let that be in the background, because it's your favorite part.
Yes,
you know, and it ends up being a cluttered mix, you know, which it happens. So Jeff did a great job of, I think, clearing some space in this record because we did record way too many parts for every single song.
Yeah.
Because we're in there, you want to record everything, but you don't need to hear everything.
Exactly.
You know?
Yep.
And Back to Life, it's a killer track.
Yeah, it really is.
The day.